This creature was so massive it had a wingspan the size of a school bus, standing as tall as a giraffe and weighing as much as an SUV, and that was flying above us in the air. That's Quetzalcoatlus for you, a true dominator of the skies. Quetzalcoatlus lived during the Late Cretaceous period, around 144 to 66 million years ago. It roamed the skies above what is now North America, from the present-day states of Texas to South Dakota. This magnificent creature was discovered in 1971 by a team of paleontologists, who unearthed the first Quetzalcoatlus fossils in Big Bend National Park in Texas. As for its physical characteristics, Quetzalcoatlus was a truly massive creature. Its wingspan was estimated to be around 33 to 36 feet, which is the equivalent of two school buses parked end to end. And when it stood on the ground, it could reach a height of up to 18 feet tall, making it one of the largest animals to ever walk the earth. Its weight is estimated to be around 250 to 500 pounds. But its size wasn't the only impressive thing about Quetzalcoatlus. Its wings were made up of a thin, leathery membrane that stretched from its body to the tips of its elongated fingers. And its wings were so strong and flexible that it could soar through the air for hours without stopping. In fact, scientists believe that Quetzalcoatlus may have been able to travel around 400 miles in a day. When it came to behavior, Quetzalcoatlus was likely a solitary creature, only coming together during mating season. Its diet consisted of mainly small animals, such as lizards, snakes, and even baby dinosaurs. But it also had a long, slender beak that could easily snatch up fish or other prey from the water surface. Now, let's dive deeper into Quetzalcoatlus's evolutionary history and its place within the pterosaur family. Pterosaurs, also known as pterodactyls, were a group of flying reptiles that lived alongside the dinosaurs during the Mesozoic era. They ranged in size from small birds to giants like Quetzalcoatlus. Quetzalcoatlus is a member of the family Asdarchidae, which is a subgroup of the pterosaurs. Asdarchids were known for their elongated necks and beaks, which they used to catch prey on the ground. In fact, the name Asdarchid comes from the Persian word Asdara, which means dragon or serpent, referring to their snake-like necks. But despite its impressive size and unique features, Quetzalcoatlus's classification has been a subject of debate among scientists. Some researchers believe that it should be classified as a separate genus within the Asdarchid family, while others argue that it is a species of the existing genus Hatzegopteryx. To study and classify Quetzalcoatlus, paleontologists have relied on a variety of methods, including the analysis of its fossils, the comparison of its skeletal structure to other known pterosaurs, and even the use of CT scans to study its internal anatomy. By examining the bones and teeth of Quetzalcoatlus, scientists have been able to determine its age, growth rate, and feeding habits, among other characteristics. Despite the ongoing debates surrounding its classification, one thing is certain: Quetzalcoatlus remains one of the most fascinating creatures to ever grace the skies. Now that we've explored the classification and evolutionary history of Quetzalcoatlus, let's take a look at the environment and ecosystem in which this giant flying reptile lived. As we have mentioned earlier, Quetzalcoatlus lived during the Late Cretaceous period, around 144 to 66 million years ago. During this time, the Earth was much warmer than it is today, and sea levels were much higher. The climate was tropical and humid, with a lot of rainfall, and the landscape was dominated by vast coastal plains and inland swamps. As it was found in what is now North America, and its fossils have been discovered in places like Texas, Montana, and South Dakota, these fossils have given us valuable insights into the range and distribution of Quetzalcoatlus, as well as the ecosystems in which it lived. Based on the geological evidence, we know that Quetzalcoatlus lived in a variety of environments, including coastal regions, wetlands, and inland plains. It likely fed on a range of prey, including fish, small mammals, and even other pterosaurs. But despite its ability to fly long distances, Quetzalcoatlus was not a migratory species. Instead, it seemed to have been more of a homebody, sticking to its preferred habitat and adapting to changes in the environment over time. Now, let's talk about its feeding habits. Based on its physical characteristics, scientists believe that Quetzalcoatlus was a carnivore, preying on a variety of small animals. Its long, toothless beak was perfect for snatching up prey, and its powerful neck muscles allowed it to quickly snap its jaws shut, delivering a lethal bite. Scientists believe that Quetzalcoatlus may have relied on a variety of hunting strategies, including scavenging, ambush attacks, and even cooperative hunting with other pterosaurs. One theory is that Quetzalcoatlus may have flown high above the ground, scanning the landscape for signs of movement or prey. Once it spotted a potential target, it would swoop down, using its powerful wings to gain speed and momentum, before delivering a swift strike with its beak. Despite its size and weight, Quetzalcoatlus was able to fly thanks to a number of unique adaptations. Its wingspan was supported by a thin, lightweight bone structure, which allowed it to take to the skies with relative ease. But perhaps even more impressive than its size was Quetzalcoatlus's ability to soar for long periods of time, using thermals and updrafts to stay aloft with minimal effort. This may have allowed it to conserve energy while searching for prey, and could have given it a distinct advantage over other predators. Of course, Quetzalcoatlus was not alone during the Late Cretaceous period. It shared its environment with a variety of other creatures, including dinosaurs and other pterosaurs. One of the most famous dinosaurs that lived during this time was Tyrannosaurus rex, a massive predator that could have easily taken down smaller animals like Quetzalcoatlus. However, there is no direct evidence of interactions between these two giants. It's possible that they simply avoided each other or lived in different parts of the ecosystem. Other pterosaurs that lived during the same time period as Quetzalcoatlus include Pterodon and Nectosaurus, both of which were smaller and had different adaptations for flight and feeding. While these creatures may have competed for similar food sources, there is no direct evidence of interactions between them and Quetzalcoatlus. However, there are some tantalizing clues that suggest Quetzalcoatlus may have interacted with other animals in its environment. For example, some fossils of Quetzalcoatlus have been found with bite marks that appear to have been made by other predators. These marks could indicate that Quetzalcoatlus was preyed upon by other creatures, or that it scavenged upon the remains of dead animals. Additionally, some scientists have proposed that Quetzalcoatlus may have engaged in a unique form of competition with other pterosaurs. Rather than fighting for food, they may have competed for access to thermals and updrafts, which were crucial for sustained flight. It's time to talk about its extinction. Quetzalcoatlus, like many other prehistoric animals, is still debated among scientists. Some theories suggest climate change and habitat loss, as well as competition for resources, contributed to its demise. However, others suggest a catastrophic event like an asteroid impact may have played a role. Regardless of the cause, watching the following video is essential to learn more about the topic and fill in any gaps in your knowledge. Despite the extinction of Quetzalcoatlus, it left a significant legacy in the scientific community. The study of its fossils has provided valuable insights into the biology and evolution of pterosaurs and other prehistoric animals. Scientists continue to study and debate the classification, behavior, and ecology of Quetzalcoatlus, using cutting-edge technology and techniques to reveal new information about these fascinating creatures. Moreover, Quetzalcoatlus has become a cultural icon and captured the public imagination. Its unique and impressive size and appearance have made it a popular subject for artists, and it continues to inspire new generations of scientists, artists, and enthusiasts alike. And if you're into cool stuff like this, make sure to click on the like and subscribe buttons below. By learning about Quetzalcoatlus and other prehistoric animals, we get a better idea of just how diverse and complicated life on Earth really is. If you're curious about other prehistoric animals and want to know more about them, then you should definitely click the video on your screen right now. We'll tell you everything you need to know about this fascinating topic and help you deepen your understanding of these incredible creatures.